Vodafone has marketed the Smart Ultra 6 as a budget 4G phone available for only £125, but this isn't evident by the design of the handset. Similar in design to the Smart Prime 6, the Smart Ultra 6 is available in both grey and silver, and boasts curved edges that provide a comfortable in-hand experience. What surprises us the most is that the Smart Ultra 6 is only 8.4mm thin, which is thinner than its little brother, the Smart Prime 6, which measures in at 9mm. It also weighs 159 grams, which is only 4 grams heavier than the Smart Prime 6, but boasts a bigger display to compensate for this fact. The Smart Ultra 6's 5.5-inch IPS multi-touch display is housed within a 154x77mm housing, which gives the device a 70% screen-to-body ratio. It boasts a full 1920x1080 resolution, equating to around 401 ppi, that provides a great viewing angles, vibrant colours, and an overall crisp display. The Smart Ultra 6 boasts 16GB of internal memory, with no other models with larger storage options currently available. This may seem like a relatively small amount of storage, but you'll be glad to know that the handset boasts a microSD slot that can boost your phone's storage by up to 128GB. It's worth noting that Vodafone decided to make the backplate non-removable, which means that you can't access the 3000mAh battery inside, a key feature for some Android users. The Vodafone Smart Ultra 6 boasts an octa-core Qualcomm Snapdragon 615 chipset, a jump up from the Smart Prime 6's quad-core Snapdragon 410 chipset, and also features 2GB of RAM. Our Geekbench 3 results puts the processing power of the handset in line with LG's 2014 flagship, the LG G3. It also boasts an Adreno 405 GPU, which is fine for casual gaming, but may not handle the latest processor-hungry 3D games. Although, with this being said, we've not found any issues with visible lag when using the phone during our testing. In terms of connectivity, along with 4G connectivity, the handset boasts Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 4.0, NFC, GPS, and an FM radio. It can also be used as a Wi-Fi hotspot, enabling access to 4G speeds on a Wi-Fi-only device. The Smart Ultra 6 boasts a 13-megapixel rear-facing camera, that boasts pretty standard smartphone camera features, including autofocus, an LED flash, and full 1080p HD video recording, with general photography being quite impressive. It's never going to compete with the camera of the LG G4, but it produces photographs with decent levels of exposure and detail. The front-facing camera isn't as impressive as the rear, but still offers a 5-megapixel camera that's capable of 720p HD video. You'll be glad to know that even though this is a Vodafone-branded handset, the branding doesn't take over as the company has been conscious of not filling it with bloatware. As a result, there's only a handful of Vodafone-branded apps and one single Vodafone-branded discovery widget. Apart from that, it's a rather vanilla implementation of 32-bit Android Lollipop 5.0.2. This almost Nexus-like user experience is a real plus point for us, keeping things easy and simple. You'll quickly get to grips with Lollipop, even if you've never used Android before. So, is the Vodafone Smart Ultra 6 worth its £125 price tag? Without a doubt. It's one of the best experiences we've had with a budget smartphone, and nothing about this phone suggests that it's budget, apart from the price tag. It won't run the latest 3D mobile games, but for everyday use, it's a great phone. And the fact that you can add up to 128GB of external storage means that there's more storage than you can shake a stick at. We award 4.5 stars and a PC Advisor recommended award.